Douglas, for Christian leaders, yes. aspiring Christian leaders who are watching this, what advice would you give them as far as what they need to do to be ready to minister, to be cultural engagers in today's world?
Right. For people who want to really do cultural engagement, not only do you have to understand culture, and we'll deal with that one and that part of it in a second, but you really have to be well trained in handling scripture. There's no two ways about it. And I know that when I was growing up, I had some family members who were wonderful people who told me, don't go to seminary, don't go get any training. You just need to go ahead and get out there on the field and get started. And in retrospect, that wasn't very good advice. And I didn't do that. I didn't follow through with that. And I realize now that that if a person wants to be able to engage culture, they have to really understand scripture. And they can't understand scripture in just a, you know, over on the surface, on the top kind of way. They have to really dig down deep in it. I have students now in my program at South, and you know, many of them, they're great students, but they did that former model. You know, they went out there and they got in ministry and they didn't prepare themselves. And now what they're learning is, I've got to go back and I've got to do preparation, because if I don't, I run out of things to say very quickly. I don't know how to engage culture. And so I think that that lifelong desire to study scripture and be engaged in the Bible is what will allow for cultural engagement.
Within our culture, we tend to be trendy, and we tend
too
to
much so.
And we tend to be
times.
And we tend to be activists. And now both of those things can be good things. I mean, trendy, that maybe has a negative feel to it for some, but I think you're saying, like, what's going on in culture, and that can be a good thing. The bad thing is we can be very unthoughtful about what's going on, and we're just like, yeah, we're going to use it for ministry, and we don't think about the impact. When I say the word activists, we're very quick to do. And there's something right about that inclination. So if you're watching this, I'm not saying that's bad. I think some of our greatest strengths can also be our biggest weakness.
Exactly.
And I think one of the weaknesses is we're not very reflective.
Right.
We're not very thoughtful. Right. And we're just so eager to do, which is good. We need to be doing. But we need to have sustained reflection.
Right.
One of the things that you enter training for, and whether that's at a church-based training or a place like Liberty or where you're teaching, is that you have time to do that, and you set aside time to reflect and drink deeply from the writings of those who went before us and learn how to interpret the Bible and think about culture. So I see that as being one of our, those two things as being our strengths, but also weaknesses.
Right. You know, being a pastor for 16 years, there, when you're a pastor, that word trend, you know, can mean different things. It can mean, hey, whatever the cool, you know, things going on, you know, if you don't wearing the right jeans, you're not wearing the right t-shirt, you know, you're not really on the right trend. Certainly I've been to pastor conferences where they recommend what wardrobe to wear and that sort of thing. And I'm only partially joking there. So, you know, I objected to that a little bit because, again, I think there is some value to that, of course. But
your wardrobe?
Well, you know, even knowing how to, you know, walk down the street without walking into a stop sign or something, yeah, it's important, okay? But the problem is that our desire to do, you know, to get the externals right, okay, is the challenge, because we want to go out and do something, and we want to go out as our tribe we're talking about here. We want to go out and we want to do something, and we want to go out and do it right. But, and we want to do, and with the right motive, you know, for the kingdom, right? Yeah. But the challenge is, though, it is very easy, as you said, for us to forget the training and the work that has to go in to that. And so for us to go out means that we have to be committed to scriptural engagement. You cannot engage with culture if you don't engage with scripture. Those two things are really, it's antithetical to say, I'm going to engage with culture and not engage with scripture. You just can't do it. when I say you can't do it, I mean, people try it all the time. But when I say you can't do it, I mean, you can't do it well. And so for students or people thinking about how do I get involved in ministry? Well, getting involved in ministry is really important. Do it. But at the same time, that includes that you're going to come back and you're also going to get involved in what it means to engage with Scripture. Mm-hmm.